Hey folks, Ben from Freemius here. This is part 2 of our guide to free trials for WordPress plugins and themes. In the previous video, we talked about why you should consider offering free trials, what the benefits and challenges are, and we got acquainted with different types of free trials. I have much more to share with you, so let's plug in, starting with the best free trial length. Before we get started, make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel for future videos. If you're watching this directly on YouTube, you can click the alert icon for notifications about new releases. After you've chosen the best type of trial, you need to decide on its length. The most common timeframes are 7, 14, and 30-day trials. But there isn't one magic number that is guaranteed to boost your conversion rate. You need to try and find the right balance between giving users enough time to understand your product's capabilities, but not too much time so that the product is put aside and forgotten. I'd recommend starting in the middle ground, a 14-day trial, and then later A/B testing with other options. From our experience, a trial longer than 14 days doesn't make much sense in the WordPress ecosystem, since most projects are set up in a very short period of time and no one really needs a trial period longer than 14 days. Another important thing to remember is to insist on providing the best support possible for users during the free trial period. Don't forget that this is also a trial period for you as a service provider. When users contact you for support, it means that they are interested in the product, and by giving a quick and helpful response, you can take the customer a step further to closing the deal. Offering free trials, as I said before, can be an easy opening for code theft. That's why you need to take some measures to protect your WordPress plugin or theme from abuse. Here are some examples. Don't just give the link to the fully featured product after the trial starts. Send the link to the user's email address. This way you'll prevent trolls from giving you a fake address just to get the product. Make sure that you limit the registration of the free trial to only one email and one site. To do this, you'll need to keep track of all the URLs or emails that use the trial and block any additional activations after the trial period has expired. When you offer a free trial with a payment method, a good way to check if the user's account is chargeable and has funds in it is to charge a very small amount, like $1, after the trial starts and then immediately refund it, sometimes called an authorization. When using this method, you need to remember that refunds usually take between 5 and 14 days, and some users won't like this unexpected charge. So if you follow that route, make that super clear to the user during checkout. The last and one of the most important tips is to ensure that when a user starts a trial, you actually create a subscription that its first payment is set to the trial expiration date, so they don't have to log back in to provide payment details. Otherwise, it will kill the conversion rate. Although offering trials is an excellent way to increase your bottom line, it also involves the danger of miscommunication between you and the customer regarding charges, refunds, and expiration dates. One of the most important things you have to take care of is delivering a very clear message on how and when charges to their account are going to be made. The last thing you want to happen is customers finding an unexpected charge from their point of view on their bank accounts. This is a very bad user experience. You need to make sure that the copy in your checkout thoroughly explains more than once what the charge is when the trial starts, what the charge will be when the trial expires, and the exact date and time of the trial expiration. A good practice is sending automated email reminders when the trial expiration is imminent. For a trial with a payment method, remind customers that there will be a charge unless requested otherwise. And for a trial without a payment method, remind them of the benefits of using your product to convince them to subscribe. In fact, on April 18th this year, according to the Nielsen report, Visa, the popular credit card with a whopping 44.8% market share worldwide, enrolled a new guideline requiring merchants to send a trial expiration reminder 7 days before initiating the first payment. We at Freemius took care of all of these automated emails, and to see exactly how it all works, click on the link to our blog post and see all the examples. One of the thoughts that comes to mind when considering trials is, why don't I offer a money-back guarantee instead of a free trial with a payment method? These two approaches offer a solution for users who want to try your product, but while they are both legitimate, you have to remember that they are both independent of each other. A free trial has an explicit time frame and is generally much clearer, and the money-back guarantee policy is usually vague and open to interpretation or abuse. A user must read the fine print to truly understand the terms of this policy. My personal advice in this case would be to go with free trials that require a payment method. This is also backed up by thorough research that showed a 16% increase in revenue for trials over money-back guarantees. I'll put a link to the research in the description below. If you still decide to go with a money-back guarantee policy, just make sure all the details are clear for the user. Another issue you face when offering trials is violating WordPress guidelines that clearly state that all features of a plugin or theme that are hosted on WordPress.org should be accessible for free all the time. This contradicts the whole concept of trials for premium features, unless the premium code is hosted on an external server. Luckily, one of the benefits of using a SaaS like Freemius is that the secure repository, the deliverability, and the fulfillment of the downloadable file are all offloaded to our deployment mechanism. When you deploy your premium plugin or theme to Freemius, the deployment mechanism automatically strips out premium code and gives you a free version of your plugin to put on WordPress.org. No premium code is provided in the free version, but users can upgrade to a free trial or your paid plans directly through the WordPress admin dashboard. That's all, folks! Our two-part guide for free trials in the WordPress ecosystem has come to an end. If you have any other questions, feel free to subscribe to our blog on freemius.com and, of course, to our YouTube channel. Thanks for watching and see you next time! Providing the best support possible for users during the after the trial starts, and then immediately refund it, sometimes called an authorization. In fact, on April 18th this year, according to the Nielsen report, Visa